And welcome back to the Holmes World Cup 2016, coming to you live from George Square in Glasgow. We've got a great matchup in the men's competition coming up for you next between Ireland and Sweden. Of course, the last game and this going out live on Unilad as well, one of the tournament's partners.
If you are the first time, welcome on to George Square for the 14th seating of the...
Okay, so Ireland have performed very, very well throughout this tournament. They've had some great results early on. They've got some powerful young players. And of course, Northern Ireland, although of course not the same but related, have had a great performance too. So we'll see these two teams coming up against each other just on pitch one. But don't forget, throughout this tournament, you can interact with us in the commentary box at any time by tweeting at TD Crosby, that's my own personal Twitter handle, or tweeting at Holmes World Cup, that's with the O of World removed, or of course you can use the hashtag HWC2016. But I am also joined by a few boys from the Unilad organisation. Nice to meet you, lads. How are you doing?
Yeah, good.
Would you like to introduce yourself to those that are listening?
Maybe people already know.
I might have known for like 10 minutes ago.
I'm Liam and Sam here.
Yeah, but don't forget, of course, although this is a live stream up on Unilad at the moment, there will, of course, be separate highlights of these games later on as well.
True.
So within 20 minutes of the game completing, on our catch-up service on YouTube, you can watch any of these games back. So I know there's a lot of interest about the Irish team in Ireland. There was last year. This Irish team, boys, last year was fantastic. They got to the final of the plate competition, which they ultimately lost to Bulgaria.
Yeah, well, I watched them this morning, and they look incredible. I think they look really, really good, very organised. They got a lot of like positive aggression and good mentality as well. Use their substitutes really well. So it could be a very interesting game.
Yeah, I mean, purely in footballing terms, the home nations and the Republic of Ireland have sent stronger squads this year than in previous tournaments, I must say. England are stronger, Northern Ireland very strong, and the Republic of Ireland fantastic. So let's see how the Republic gets underway as we kick off. I'll bring you these teams as and when I can as we see who is on the field. So for the Republic of Ireland, we have number 6, Michael McDowell on the field. We have also got number 3, Dean O'Connell. Keep your eyes on Dean O'Connell, the number 3 high goal scorer in some of Ireland's early games. For Sweden, we have the number 9, Fredrik Axgren on the field. Big Fredrik Axgren at the back there. We've also got the number 20, Johan Beauregard. Irish goalkeeper, number 1, John Farrell. Been fantastic throughout this tournament. But here's a bit of an opportunity for Ireland to build on that natural 3-on-2 overlap. Ranging run by the number 6, McDowell in the middle. Out to O'Connell. O'Connell back to the centre. And there's the space. And there's the strike. Wow. Irish number 6, Michael McDowell. Fantastic effort by the boys in, well, the boys in white today, not the boys in green, are they, lads? So is there a chance you could tell us a little bit more? That's the second goal. I tried to get an interview in there. Yeah. Couldn't. The Irish far too quick for me. Dean O'Connell with his first goal of the game. That's one for O'Connell. One for Michael McDowell, the number 6, who's back on the ball now.
There's another here. I can feel it. There's another.
Yeah, we can. This overlap, this 3-on-2, the Irish work this really well. Mm-hmm. And when we get a little lull in play, I will try and get some sort of interview questions off to you boys in the commentary. You find out a bit more about this Unilad partnership.
Yeah, look, you mentioned earlier that the teams are getting stronger this year, and I think that stems from the whole tournament getting more exposure. More people want to be involved. They can get better kits. They can get better boots. They can get better training. And hopefully next year, with the help of what we're doing, it's going to get even bigger.
Well, of course, this stream is the most popular stream on Facebook at the moment, just to blow our own horns. And of course, 3,000 views already over the 3 days. So we're well on course to break that 1 million mark. Good diving save, though, by Nathman Asberg in goal for Sweden. Tough, though.
Is he good?
Dean O'Connell. That's the brace already. So that's 3 for Ireland, nothing for Sweden. Don't forget, do tweet in if you are watching from anywhere in the Republic. These boys represent counties all over your country, so do let us know using the hashtag HWC2016. Ball with the keeper there. Taking his time.
We have Mambo number 5 playing.
Yeah, well, it's nice to see the level of background music can vary quite dramatically, I must say, guys.
Hope we got the licensing rights to that.
We got another.
There we go, that's three. Neat little tackle, though, by the number 5, Daniel Ockstrand.
Oh, one of the Swedish players wants to come off already, goodness.
Well, you'll see rolling substitutions throughout the games, of course, because we've got 8 players on a team, rolling subs, and each team is encouraged to use all the players as much as possible. It's considered against fair play to essentially play your best 3 the entire tournament.
I think it's that's one of the best things that I've seen from this tournament so far, is like the fair play. It's been unbelievable, and I was saying in the last game, I think the professional game could learn a lot from these guys.
Because of course the skill level is still quite strong, and we say skill level. That's the 3rd ranging run by Dean O'Connell. Didn't get anything out of that. It's only had 2 goals this game. But you see how well the Irish run with the ball in attack. It's a different style of play to what we normally see from sort of nations from the British Isles as such. You don't see that sort of attacking single man play very often.
Well, they're not afraid to have a shot either. I've seen a lot of teams do very slow build-up play. And kind of hope that one opportunity every 3 minutes or whatever. But these guys go for it. It's nice to see.
Well, yeah, of course. We've got a great shot off there by O'Connell and by the Irish number 8. Both ultimately denied by the boards and the post. But Ireland are able to sneak goals from basically anywhere in this one, it seems.
Can you score from behind the halfway line?
You can. The reason that halfway line is there is because...
The defender.
Yeah, because the defender. We can't have all 3 players in defence at any one time. Mm. So it creates that natural 3-on-2 overlap. And it's also used as a penalty line as well. That's where penalties will start from. Penalties are a bit more like the old MLS penalties, if you remember them. The sort of one-on-one run. Rather than the... That's another effort by O'Connell. That's his hat-trick. 3 for O'Connell. 1 for Michael McDowell. I think Ireland might have a new hero.
Oh.
Robbie Brady was, of course, good in the Euros.
I thought you were about Michael Flatley.
Oh, no, not at all. Robbie Brady was fantastic, ex-Hull City man. Brilliant to see him do so well against the Italians. But there we go. That's a nice effort. That's slotted in by the Swedish number 5, Daniel Ockstrand. No, but we're back again. And that was almost an immediate response by the Irish. Number 6 and goal scorer Michael McDowell unable to reply in kind to that Swedish effort from Ockstrand. But here he is again. Here's his 4th. Dean O'Connell. Get him on a poster. Get him in Panini football albums. This kid's amazing. Number 20 on the field. Bergegaard. Bit slim, a bit more rangy for the Swedes. Number 6 as well, Vestling in defence, alongside number 7, Thomas Teschke. The referee, of course, Harry Millas from Melbourne, made his debut at the Australian tournament.
Composure.
We've got Brian Nevin on the field for Ireland. That's the number 4. Nevin still the option on the outside. Excellent tackle, though. Vestling had to be there and was.
Is that a penalty?
It is. Goalkeeper's left his own area there. So that's Harry Millas, the referee, calling for a penalty. Looks like it's number 20, Johan Bergard, to take up against John Farrell in the Irish goal.
That's a great save.
Farrell's tipped that onto the bar. Fantastic effort by John Farrell. Didn't even get the bounce in at the end as well. Perfect by the Irishman. Good shot by Nevin.
Oh, he's down. He's
fabulous.
Down.
But that, yeah, that's a...
That's a bit of a Matty V, really, wasn't it?
That's a bit of a Matty V.
He's taken that very hard, hasn't he, the number 4? That might well be Matthias Nevonen. Don't have the number 4 on my team sheet, but of course, these players can sign up so late to a tournament. It's difficult to often see like who's going to come. Some teams have had to drop out with like 2 or 3 days remaining because the visa troubles in the country are so acute.
Yeah, imagine.
I mean, I don't know if any of you guys have been able to see as you've been ranging around the site today, Street Soccer United, the team that plays in white and dark blue.
Is that the refugee team?
Yeah, they're a refugee side. They're made up from Street Soccer, which is a Scottish program that's heavily involved, of course, with this tournament. And that team are all refugees that are in Scotland, either seeking asylum or refugee status.
They have a great kit as well.
It's fabulous.
It is a great kit.
And speaking of kits as well, of course, if any of you are watching from Scotland, if you are in Glasgow and you are thinking of coming down, you can buy official merchandise of extremely high quality for the Scottish national side at a little booth just behind our commentary box. It's beautiful stuff. So you can get a Scotland shirt if you want to play your five-a-side in a similar style.
Have you had a kickabout on the pitch yet?
No, I had a few at the end of the tournament last year. Because we do most of our commentary standing, though, I'm not sure how good I'd be by the end of these days. Look at that for another good ranging run by the number 7, Adrian Power.
He's very good.
Recognisable Adrian Power by the short crop ginger hair.
James McLean.
Very much so. 7-on-7. Ball goes back to Farrell. Long ball to Power, well brought down. Goalkeeper's left his own area. Harry Milas waves that away. But that ball's bounced back off the post, back off the keeper and hasn't gone in. For me, that should have been a penalty to the Irish. But as they got, it's a terrible kick out by the goalkeeper, slotted underneath his legs. Irish number 4, Brian Nevin, first of the game.
So what do you think about goal line technology next year?
Goal line technology, look, as long as we have at least one Russian linesman, I don't really mind, boys. That'll do me, to be perfectly honest with you.
That's a cool cap finish.
Adrian Power, slotting that cool home. So what you see about this side is some teams will make substitutions and, you know, the strength in depth might change quite considerably. The Irish side, it's like for like.
That's a great finish.
Look at that.
Could we be on 10? 10?
Slotted round. That's Jamie Geegan. 10 is possible. We've seen a 17-0 scoreline earlier in the tournament. But, of course, if one team does start to dominate the other, often orders do come up from on high to sort of calm that down a little bit. Because goal difference doesn't matter in this tournament. It's disciplinary record that controls whether a team will progress should they be tied in the group. Yeah, injured number 4 for Sweden back on the pitch now.
He is.
And all corners and throw-ins are rolled in, as proved by Johan Bergegaard, the number 20. Bit of space for Ireland.
Should have done better there.
Bit too outstretched, wasn't it? You could have pulled that back, that ball back. He had Adrian Power in space. There could have been an option off the back of that. Power again. Back to the another finish. Is that about the second time Jamie Geegan's been able to just slot balls in from the halfway line?
Too easy.
Not for the first time today either. This morning he'd done a couple of them.
I mean, I'm sure I'm speaking for a lot of people who would watch this stream from home. A lot of us play football. A lot of us play five-a-side, four-a-side, six-a-side. The skill level on show here is lightning fast and miles past what I can achieve, to be honest.
But that's why it's so entertaining. It's just goals.
Well, it's set up, of course, in an attacking structure as well. It's not set up to be defensive, as you could argue Euro 2016 might have been.
Yeah, some of those matches were just so boring, but at least with this you get the instant satisfaction. The Ireland as a team are just so rapid.
And of course, there's not a person that goes out onto that pitch that isn't in some way a bit of a hero.
Yeah, exactly.
And doesn't have their own story. If you want to look at some of these players' stories, get on www.homelessworldcup.org, where you can look through player profiles, profiles of our ambassadors, and get a little bit more history of this game.
And we have a documentary coming out as well later on.
Fantastic. Where will that be for people?
So that'll be on the main Unilad page. And that's going to have a lot of the stories from the guys here as well. Some of which are really, really quite powerful.
Well, of course, if anybody wants to take a look at YouTube.com/Homeless World Cup, they'll be able to see the Indonesian games. Now, the Indonesian goalkeeper has one of his feet amputated. We've had a goal in this gap. A first goal for Jason Martin and another goal for Adrian Power. But the Indonesian goalkeeper has a foot amputated and the other leg is amputated just below the knee. And he is one of the best goalkeepers in this tournament. Sincerely. It's a beautiful thing to watch. So do take a look at the Indonesian games if you get a chance to look on YouTube as well.
And they're playing at 4:20 today, I think.
Yeah, they are playing another game today. They are playing 4:20 against Cambodia. Adrian Power. Ball out wide to Jason Martin. Back to Power again in the centre. Of course, Ireland are deadly from all ranges.
I think it's amazing, though, that even a team who gets beaten, you know, 11-1 is still happy to just have a bit of fun. Well, like, it's weird. I've never seen anything quite like it before.
Yeah, I mean, what's important as well is that you've joined this tournament on day three. Now, as the tournament goes along, these groups, after the first group stage, we'll have a second group stage where the top teams will play each other and the bottom teams will play into another group.
Right.
Then we'll hit a trophy stage as well. So every team will compete for some sort of cup. Every team will play right and through to the end of the tournament. So there'll be a time when a team like Sweden,
gorgeous,
brilliant
finish.
Power from Power again. Well, there'll be a time when a team like Sweden will be up against Italy or France. They won't be coming up against Ireland or Chile or Mexico.
Right.
And the games will get closer, the games will get tighter and arguably more exciting as well. Brilliant defence, though, by the Irish. Did leave Farrell for dead in goal, though. Another opportunity for the Irish to build. Of course, speaking of Farrells, Colin Farrell's one of the ambassadors for this game. He was at Amsterdam last year.
Mm.
And there's been talk, although I'm not quite sure how finalised it's been, because he does narrate Kicking It, the documentary about the Homeless World Cup.
Okay.
But there's talk of a fiction film starring him about our island's trip to Paris in 2011. On the cards, we're not quite sure about that, but it'd be nice to see that as well to raise the profile of this
amazing
sporting spectacle.
Might see a DVD released of
the island team.
For both Euros and the Homeless World Cup.
I know, of course. Good save, though, by the Swede. Nathan Asberg been under a lot of pressure from this Irish team. Nothing he's been able to really do about it because the placement has been so perfect.
What's the best goal that you've seen scored this tournament?
If anybody wants to take a look on YouTube, there should be a clip on YouTube from the Mexican team. I believe it's the Mexican number 6 who knocks that goal in. Might be Lopez, I believe his name is. And he chests the ball 3 times, lets it bounce and volleys it in. I was in with Honey Talngia, who's one of the ambassadors during that clip. So there's a good sort of 12-second clip of my commentary with Honey Talngia of that goal. It's stunning.
What's this chest made of?
I don't know, but he takes the first chest, he goes very high, then again, lets it drop and powers it in. It's a beautiful finish.
Unbelievable. I heard about the women's Greek goalkeeper.
Yeah, she's fabulous. She's fabulous. Neat little goal by Brian Nevin, just to round things off. The Greek goalkeeper, she won the Fair Play Award for Player of the Day, because there's a lot of these players who've never played football before, to be honest, boys. So some people, obviously the Irish, have come from a footballing background. The Greek women's team really haven't. So what they bring to the tournament is very different, and they're great around camp. It's great to see.
14-1.
It's like an IKEA product code.
So there we go. 14 for Ireland, 1 for Sweden. That's a result from pitch 1. Don't forget, if you want to get involved with this tournament, you can at youtube.com/homelessworldcup, facebook.com/homelessworldcup, and of course on UniLad 2. Look out for that documentary coming to a homepage near you soon. What a goal, though, by the Irish number 5, Jamie Geegan. Quality all across the field, and that's the team working together at the end.
I think every team should do that.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. There's no Klinsmann that's not big enough for that, is it?
Yeah.
Well, it's been a pleasure to have you down.
Thank you very much.
Pleasure to be on UniLad's stream, and
perfect.
We'll catch you again if we can later in
amazing
the week. Cheers, boys.
Thank you ever so much.